Subscribe, damn it! The hell is wrong with you?
We are less than 24 hours away from the inauguration of the first black president in the history of the United States of America. And if you're like me, many of you are very excited to be alive, to experience this opportunity, and are optimistic about what the future holds. But with that said, I also want to challenge you to understand the responsibility that comes with having our first black president. Let us backtrack a moment. I think back to the night when Barack Obama won the presidency. The votes were counted, or not all of them were counted, but enough were counted to establish victory. And I remember watching the coverage of Grant Park in Chicago, and seeing the millions of people, or thousands of people, I should say, jubilant about their victor. And there were many tears and many emotions. And as I sat in my home and watched, the funny thing is that I wasn't emotional, and I was not. I was very stoic. In many ways, I was kind of like Barack Obama when he came on and began speaking. While I'm sure there was joy inside him, within his face there was a seriousness and a reality of what he had accomplished. For me, it was pretty much the same, because I, like many of you, understood that what he had won, in essence, was a wealth of problems that many of us may never understand, and only a select few who are watching this may ever have the opportunity to experience the problems that he currently has on his desk. And I remember thinking to myself, we now have a black president. What does that mean to me? And in all honesty, it meant something that I had said in the Virgin Chronicles, and that simply is everything and nothing. To have our first black president means that all of us and our children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren can now dream of accomplishing anything with at least one factual reference to note that it is possible. And that is very powerful. But at the same time, it doesn't change the reality that we as black people face in a country that is still filled with a select few of individuals who are determined to continue their racist beliefs. It means everything for the families of slaves that existed in America. Yet it means nothing for the young man who was shot while in handcuffs by the police.
The video shows three men sitting on the platform against the wall. 22-year-old Oscar Grant is in the middle. The two officers seem to be concerned with Grant and the person to the right. The third man sits for the most part alone with his hands up. At one point, Grant gets up and they push him back down. There seems to be some kind of struggle, although you can't hear what's being said between Grant and the officers. About a minute into the video, another officer steps in and pushes Grant back to the ground. About 15 seconds later, one officer puts his knee on Grant's head, and the other officer seems to do a pat down. Then he pulls his gun, and a second later fires what would be a fatal shot.
It means everything for the generations of Black people, even up to today, that felt hopeless. Yet at the same time, it means nothing to those who may be denied loans or opportunities based on the color of their skin. The significance of having a Black president is the reality that America has progressed forward, and that the hard work of the civil rights leaders who existed before us in some ways have not gone in vain. Their tireless work ethic to create an opportunity of endless possibilities for our generation and those that will precede us has now, in some form, validated its purpose and validated their efforts. But it is important that as Black people, that we do not forget nor ignore the responsibility that will affect each and every one of us by having our first Black president. The flip side to this joyous occasion is that because of the achievement of one man, in some ways it can be used against us to say that life and opportunity is equal. And while there is some truth in that, there is also a plethora of truth that equality still has a long way to go. It is not my intent to damper your spirits or to lessen the joy that all of you and all of us should feel in our hearts at this monumentous accomplishment. However, I do feel it is my responsibility to remind you of the responsibility that comes with one man's achievement. Now, this may surprise many of you and may even anger some, but the truth is that I did not vote for Barack Obama. Now, don't get it twisted, I damn sure didn't vote for John McCain. But the reason why I did not vote for Barack Obama is basically twofold. Reason number one is because I knew he would win, with or without my vote. I knew my vote would help him, but I knew he would win even if I did not vote, because I understood the drive that we have as people to accomplish the good. But the major reason that I chose not to vote for Barack Obama is because I wasn't inspired to vote for the first Black president. I am actually more inspired to vote for the second or third. And I say that because I don't want change to be a one-time occasion. For me personally to believe in change, it has to be consistent and it has to be long-lasting. And if in my lifetime I am able to witness a second, third, or maybe even fourth minority president, then I know that America has moved forward completely.
Damn it!